guys. Steven and Clayton here this morning at our home farm in Indiana. Nice and chilly. We finally had our first cold front. These leaves are really holding. So we found a scrape line here right next to our soybean field. We still haven't taken the beans out. So the deer are coming through here real hard. It's gonna be really nice. It's November the 1st. Like I said, this cold front has really got them moving. That big eight pointer has been coming in. So hopefully him or maybe even another, and you know, some other deer that we don't know of. But they're starting to move. So hopefully you all are having some luck. Hopefully we will too. So stay tuned. We'll see how this day goes.
Right.
That big eight decided to come in just a little before 9 o'clock. He stayed out in the bean field a little farther than what we thought. We figured he would hit this scrape line. I slung an arrow, but had one tree limb right here that I nicked. Shot the arrow up, went right over his back. Man, talk about getting your heart, but he is tall, the big deer. Made me sick. We're gonna stick it out and see what else happens. Maybe he'll come back, maybe something else come out, who knows.
Split.
down, buddy. Right there, buddy. He's down.
November 1st, and I just killed a giant. We put in this set yesterday at noon. We had a big scrape line coming in right here. We knew they were hot in here. I literally, 5 minutes ago, just missed that big, tall eight-pointer. I popped a tree limb. I was devastated. Kid you not, a freaking buck comes in right there, and we thought it was the eight-pointer coming back. Nope. It was this giant that we've never even seen before. And he quartered away right here. I barely slipped it through those tree limbs right there. We wanted to be in nice and tight in here. Man, he ran right out here, bypassed, right past the bean field. And he went down. We got a giant on the ground, guys. This Hoyt freaking laid it to him. Laid it to him. He's hurt. Whew, man. We are absolutely pumped. That's what it's about right there. Hey.
Yeah, there we go, guys. Right here he is. He didn't even make a lot of field. Made it back to the pin line.
Dandy right there. The mainframe 10 with the split G2. He come in just on a string. I grunted at him. He was ready to fight. Unfortunately, I missed that 8-pointer this morning. You know, I hit a tree branch, and it wasn't just a few minutes later this guy comes in. And you know, that's one thing to remember, guys. Is you know, yeah, I was really upset, but. You know, I sat there and thought about it and thought, you know, hey, maybe something else will come out, or maybe he'll circle back around. You know, it's on in Indiana. They're getting pretty rowdy. Anyways, we're excited. We're gonna get some pictures and get this puppy dressed out and see what he weighs and scores. And thanks a lot. We appreciate everything. See you on the next round. Clayton will be in the hot seat next.
Welcome to Midwest Whitetail East. It is the 22nd of October. Shot my buck this morning with my Hoyt, still wound up about that, and got the buck back, got him in the cooler, and slipped out tonight to the farm. This edge of the farm, we're having a lot of deer damage and deer issues over here, so a lot of doe tags for this farm, and brought the inline out tonight, so we're gonna see if we can shoot a doe tonight with the inline. A bear in tonight as well, so if a bear comes in or a doe comes in, hopefully we'll be able to bring you some action here from Midwest Whitetail East.
Thank you.
10 minutes away from the end of legal shooting light, and I was watching deer. There was a little wide buck and two little ones out here earlier, and something spooked them down here, and I don't know why they ran off. And then the deer started to pour into the field 10 minutes before the end of legal shooting light. Had a great big doe step out here about 85 yards, and this field was just full of deer tonight, so hopefully made a good shot on her. Felt pretty good. Once I shot, the woods filled with smoke, but the inline went off on the first trigger pull, so hopefully she's laying out here, and we can find her pretty quickly, and I'll put another deer in the freezer. Thanks for watching Midwest Whitetail East. An exciting day.